Hello everyone, assalamu alaikum. So here we'll take a look how to use Cubit to load JSON data. Now here is my JSON data, and for this JSON data I have a model class over here. Now the class itself has fromJSON method. Now fromJSON method is a part of any kind of classic model where you get the data as a JSON and you want to convert it to an object. So that's why you will have fromJSON method. Now let's take a look at our main.dart file over here. Inside this I have multi-block provider. Now I have many providers. One of the providers is this one. Now over here, actually inside this block provider, I'm injecting or I'm saying, okay, so this is my block or qubit. So in our case, instead of using block, we are using qubit. Now what is qubit? I think you already know that qubit is part of block. So if you don't want to use all the functionalities of block, you may just go ahead with qubit and it makes your life easier. You do have to remember that qubit is part of block or subset of block. Now there's another big difference directly using block and qubit is that for block you might use events or call an event from your UI, and based on that event you may trigger states, and the states would trigger rebuild of your UI. But in case of qubit, we are going to call method, and inside this method will emit states. Okay, so this is what you see. So this is our method. So this method will call from our class over here, main.dart file, and inside this provider, as you see, first we create an instance of our qubit. Now if you're going to use qubit, of course your qubit, your class has to extend qubit. So these are class, and this class is extending qubit. We are calling this class a qubit class, but of course this name is works out qubit. Just like block, we create a block and extend the block class. In our case, we are creating qubit and extending the qubit class. Anyway, so we create an instance of this, and then we check for that instance, are there any states or not. Definitely first time when your app boots up, you'll not have any states, so states are empty. Now if states are empty, I can check that using this condition, and based on that, actually I can call method, as I said earlier. So in block you call the events or add events, but in qubit you just directly call the method. So this is the method that we are calling, and as we call, actually we load our JSON data, as you can see over here. Then we save it in a variable, and after that actually we do some fancy stuff. Now this stuff actually has to do with converting our string to, which is like JSON. So from that JSON we convert it to an object, and then we return an object. So it's more like nested models that I have over here. But the idea is, if you call a method, in that method inside this you can load your JSON file, and then you do some necessary operation like converting those string from those JSONs to an object, and then you can save it somewhere. And once that is done, you just emit new states, and that's what we have done over here. We are emitting new states. Now if you emit new states, of course your states, they are not going to be empty, and this is what we'll see over here. So we can say over here, states are not empty. So that's what we'll see. Okay, now at the same time, as you see in our UI itself, we also have block provider. We are injecting our qubit and states. Now first we check if we have empty state or not. If it is not empty, then we show a return a widget and we say it's loaded. If we are empty, then we also print a message, and at the same time we show on the UI that it is loading. Okay, so let's go ahead and restart everything. Now to get it better, I'll delete it first and then reinstall everything so that we understand what's going on. So let's go ahead and restart it. Now as you see that our method, which is called get works out being called, now actually this is over here. So this is the method that gets called, and we printed this message. Okay, and after that we see that it says that we are loading. Now it's coming from here, from this UI, because it checks if state is empty or not. If it is empty, then we say, hey, it's loading. At the same time we show it on the UI, but because the state changes very quickly. So this becomes this one or this one very quickly, immediately, because the JSON data loads very fast. And then we also see that states are being emitted, because once we are done over here, we print a message that it's being emitted. And after that, actually, we can check whether our state is empty or not. Here it says it's loaded, which means our state is not empty. Now, we'd restart it one more time, and you'll see that we would see for a very short time here it says loading. So you need to take a look at it carefully. Yeah, it was there for a very short time. Okay, and we also see that from loading, it becomes loaded. Yes, so that's how simply you just load your data, JSON data, parse JSON data using Cubit. Thank you.